Greetings, this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Our talk today focuses on the thermal management system that Tesla uses along with its batteries. Bonjour, vi gates, vi stays no chemos par banen, strasviche, ni hao ma. My talk today focuses on the fact that most of the time we're all focused on which battery Tesla is using versus the battery packs that are used by their competitors. A good friend of mine who has a PhD in mechanical engineering was pointing out that the thermal management system used by Tesla is superior, and it's a competitive advantage that really needs to be, you know, looked at in terms of better understanding why sort of Tesla and its batteries is a better solution. So one of the ways I could articulate it that I found was interesting is the fact that if you look at the female body, a woman's body temperature can vary as much as 60 degrees to accommodate the needs of those cells that she's carrying. And, you know, obviously to keep them healthy, that's why the temperature swing could be so dramatic. Well, it turns out that in terms of either heating up the cells when it comes to a management process, or cooling the cells down if they're too hot, these are some of the things that the thermal management system does, among other things that it does for the batteries. As you know, Tesla went the direction of having small cells, which turns out to be easier to manage when it comes to temperature issues, while most of its competitors chose to go for larger cells that are in packets because it's lower cost. So what ended up happening is that even though sort of the Tesla solution has been found to be superior, many of those companies and their partners, those companies being mostly Korean manufacturers in LG or Samsung, etc., have aligned with BMW, even Mercedes now, and GM to produce these packet-based cells. And one of the issues that they're having is that while the packet is a cheaper way to go, the challenge they're having is when it comes to things like supercharging, they're stuck because their management system isn't really set up to handle the temperature management challenges of batteries when you're doing supercharging or activities like that. So I expect, particularly after Samsung's comment, when the so one of my expectations is that, based on Samsung's comment regarding replicating the 2170 battery by 2021, I'm expecting that we'll see a dramatic shift by most competitors towards the 2170 size battery, and then building their own thermal control systems that go with it. But for now, sort of Tesla is the standard, and that advantage allows them to not only control the market currently in a monopolistic way, but also they keep innovating, so they keep providing more of a gap. I kept thinking to myself, after, you know, why was it that all these companies hadn't just quickly moved to the 18650 battery, and then now everybody would be on the same standard and we're moving along? But there's some real engineering work to be done to even achieve parity with Tesla on the 18650 batteries. So it's not like it hasn't been recognized that the 18650 and now 2170 battery architectures are a good idea. The problem is, again, it's not just about the battery. The thermal control systems are pretty significant in terms of how they help the situation in terms of the battery's management. I brought up the issue with women and body temperature varying relative to the needs of the cells. And I really think that that is an important thing to note, because in essence, if you're an owner slash manager of your vehicle, one of the things that you're actually doing is having to think through your activities relative to the needs of your battery. One quick example that popped to mind that I was surprised by is I visited a Tesla office, and one of the workers there made a comment to me that, you know, there are other sort of high-speed methods for that one could use, and you didn't necessarily have to use a Tesla charger with a supercharger if it was available. And after understanding better the thermal control and how the Tesla cars speak to the supercharger and how temperature is managed in that process, and how critical it is that that temperature is managed so you don't destroy cells or blow up the battery, you know, I wouldn't even consider any other supercharging activity with a Tesla vehicle that was not a Tesla situation, so that you benefit from all the technology that's unseen. I will definitely be presenting more on this in the future. In this case, I wanted to sort of just introduce the fact that, you know, the thermal control systems are critical to the management of these batteries. And it's very easy to move away from how important it is, but in a lot of ways, it's harmonious work with the batteries are why Tesla has such a big advantage, and why it remains the best solution for most folks, and even after 5 years of being out there, has not been caught by competitors. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. I look forward to your comments and input. I actually think this, please like and subscribe. I think the thermal management issues for any owner or potential owner are big, because it helps understand how to manage your battery in the best ways to get a winning situation. Thanks, and have a great day.